Hello, everybody, and welcome back to The Walking Dead Season 1. Last time we did Episode 1 and completed it. That was a new day. Now we're going on to Starve for Help. Now, by the picture, I don't think things are going too well. I mean, yeah. Let's just hop right into it.
I know who you are.
I got one for you.
You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah, I want my parents to come home now.
And you keep an eye on that front door. You're our lookout.
It's Doug. You got it.
And I'm Carly.
Okay, Carly. You'll shift in with Doug when...
You got it, boss.
Son of a bitch. One of them is bitten.
We reason with him.
With the bloody end of an axe handle, maybe. Nobody threatens my boy.
Oh my God.
And I don't give a shit about what happens to you. But if anything happens to my daughter or that little girl you've got with you, you watch your ass.
All right, so last time went pretty well, I guess. I don't know, not really. It literally took forever to load. I don't know why, but it finally loaded, though. Yeah, already into it. Axe and zombies. Saved lots. Oh, hello.
Damn it. What'd they get this time?
Looks like a rabbit.
Well, that's another meal lost. I still can't believe we went through all that commissary food in 3 months. It seemed like so much at the time.
Maybe you shouldn't have opened the door.
Yeah, except then I'd probably be food by now. Trust me, I have no regrets.
Rabbit's hardly a meal, Mark, but I'd take it. We're all hungry.
No kidding. When I accidentally grabbed for Carly's rations the other night, I thought she was gonna take off my hand.
We're all on edge. Just cut us some slack.
Yeah, you're right. I wish I knew for sure how much food we have left.
We'll manage.
Maybe. You know, some people aren't too happy about the way Lily's handling rations.
Lily knows it's important to keep the adults fed and functioning. Sometimes that means someone's gotta miss a meal.
You think Kenny's having any more luck than we are out here?
I sure hope so.
Yeah, between the lack of food and Kenny and Lily fighting all the time, things are getting pretty tense back at the motor inn. You know, Kenny's been talking about taking off if he can get that RV running.
He's got a wife and son to look out for.
And they're safest in a big group. Going out on his own will get them all killed. Can't blame him, though. Did you hear Larry going off on him last night? What's the old guy's deal, anyway? Seems like he's got a problem with you in particular.
Larry's just looking out for his daughter.
Hey, I know Lily. She can take care of herself. He needs to take that energy and put it towards finding us some more food. And I know Lily thinks she's getting weaker. But the guy's all muscle. He's a walking pile driver.
Yeah.
I wouldn't want to be stuck in a room with him. And didn't he punch you in the face one time?
Knock me flat. Don't. Gunshot'll bring walkers. One bird's not worth it.
Yeah, I know. I'm just really frickin' hungry.
Shit! Was that Kenny?
I don't know. Come on!
Uh-oh. Who was it?
Jesus Christ.
Oh, shit. No, no. Please don't kill us. We just want to help our teacher. We'll leave, I swear.
Lee, you guys okay?
Get it off. Get it off. God damn it. Get it off me.
Travis, maybe they can help.
These might be the same guys that raided our camp, and we barely got away from that.
What guys?
Why the fuck is there a bear trap out here?
Who raided your camp?
I don't know. Guys with guns.
Please, we won't bother you, I swear.
Lee, this is fucked up. We've gotta help him. Please.
Ben, shut up. My dad was Special Forces. I know what I'm doing.
Just see if you can get him out. After that, you can leave us or whatever. I don't care. Please.
We gotta get him out of there.
Oh, God, thank you.
Fine, but you gotta hurry.
Hurry, please. Hurry.
Lee, this trap's been altered. There's no release latch.
Oh, no.
Shit! Walkers! It's now or never, Lee!
Please! Get me out of this!
Mark, get the boys back! Kenny, keep those walkers off of me!
There's so much blood.
Lee, do stop, something!
Stop! Stop! Please! Get me...
Oh, man. Oh, man.
No!
Stop!
Fuck!
You have to get him out. You have to.
No.
Let's go. Let's go.
Oh, God.
I'm gonna have to cut you out.
No. Try the trap.
It has to be
anything,
now.
Please.
Oh, God. Ah! Damn it, Lee. Just cut off his fucking legs.
We don't have time for that.
Oh, man.
I'm sorry, but we have to go. Now. Lee, I can't keep...
Oh, God!
Shit. Is he...
He passed out.
If he's alive, grab him and let's go.
Behind you!
Travis!
Come on, we gotta move!
Help! Oh my God! Help! Help me!
Damn.
No!
Someone's already dead. Yep. I already lost one person. That's a great start, huh? Do you want a hammer, maybe? Do they have that rock? Clementine.
The gate's open! We've got wounded!
Shit! What the hell are they doing?
Come on!
Oh my God! What happened?
Where's that?
What the hell? What's going on?
I don't have time to explain.
Lee, our Are you okay?
Get him into the truck. I'll see what I can do.
Cat, okay? Can you fix him?
Jesus, Ken!
Lee!
I don't know.
Lee! What the hell? You can't just be bringing new people here. What are you thinking?
Hey, you want to calm down for a fucking minute?
No, I don't. I want to know why you thought bringing more mouths to feed was a good idea.
He would have died if we left him.
So what?
We are not responsible for every struggling survivor we come across. We have to focus on our group, right here, right now.
Well, hang on. We haven't even talked to these people yet. Maybe they can be helpful.
Come on, Lily. These are people. People trying to survive just like us. We've got to stick together to survive.
The only reason you're here is because you had food. Enough for all of us. But that food is almost gone. We've got maybe a week's worth left. And I don't suppose you guys are carrying any groceries, are you?
No.
Fine, you guys fight it out then. Welcome to the family, kid.
Come over here and see what I drew.
What? No, I...
Just come on, okay?
You know, you like to think you're the leader of this little group, but we can make our own goddamn decisions. This isn't your own personal dictatorship.
Oh, come on, you're being dramatic. Everything always turns into a power struggle between you two. I'm not gonna be a part of that.
Hey, I didn't ask to lead this group. Everyone was happy to have me distributing the food when there was enough to go around, but now that it's running out, suddenly I'm a goddamn Nazi.
It doesn't matter who's in charge. Those people are here now. I guess we just have to decide what happens
no,
next.
No, Lee, it does matter. One person can't be in charge of everything. You know, it might feel safe for you to sit on the fence, but sooner or later, you're gonna have to decide whose side you're on.
I don't see any of you stepping up to make the hard decisions. My girl's got more balls than all of you combined.
Dad, please. Why don't you go help Mark with the wall? You think this is easy for me? Everyone's starting to hate me because I'm the one that rations the food, but nobody else wants to. You know what? I'm not doing it tonight. You do it. There's today's food rations, but there's not enough for everyone. Good luck.
All right. Four food items. Kids come first. Clammy and, Clam, Duck, Ben. I'm not gonna keep it for myself, because I'm a nice person like that. What do you think Clementine would like? What? Alright. What do you think? What would Clementine like?
How you doing, Clementine?
Okay.
Where's your hat?
I don't know. Can you help me find it?
Sure. When did you lose it?
I had it a couple days ago.
I promise. If I find it, I'll let you know.
Thank you.
Okay, Clem. I've got to take care of some things. Why don't you go back to playing with Duck for a while?
Okay.
How you doing, Clementine? Everything all right?
Yeah. Is that man going to be okay?
I'm not sure.
I hope he will. I'm so hungry, Lee. I hope I get to eat soon.
You will.
Here, Clem. You need something to eat.
Half an apple. I'll give you crackers and cheese.
Okay. A sundae would be better next time.
I'll keep that in mind.
If you have any more food, Duck is hungry too.
Yeah, why don't we gonna get some food?
Right now, Duck.
Hey, Duck. How about a little food? Here.
Yeah. Oh man, I'm so hungry.
Should I give one to Lily? I give one to Ben. I give him the want jerky. Want something to eat?
If your camp got raided, probably means you haven't eaten in a while.
I am really hungry. Thanks.
Some of these people have gone longer than me without food. They're the ones that need it.
Sure.
Here.
I don't want anything from you.
Fine.
All right.
At least the kids have something to keep them occupied.
Who should I give the apple to? Kenny? Yeah.
Want something to eat? Here, Kenny, take this.
How about my boy? He eat yet?
Yeah, I gave him something.
Sure, then hand it over. I'm starved. Thanks.
I tried giving Lily food, but she didn't want it. So.
Not such an easy job, is it? It's okay. I know you're still watching out for me.
I don't envy you. I don't know how you have the strength to do this every day.
I don't have a choice.
Hey, thanks for looking out for me and my family.
Yeah, of course.
Still, I guess some people aren't going to be happy with your choices.
You're out! What happened to my food?
There's none left.
You keep treating people like this, and your days in this group are numbered.
You're one to talk, old man.
Yeah, well, I don't see you working on that wall.
Get Trump to do it. He'll work on the wall. Trump 2016. Alright, this game predicted the future. I'll talk to Clem for a little bit.
That thing doesn't work anymore, does it?
No, not since it broke at the drugstore.
Just gonna hold on to it then?
Yeah, if that's okay. I need it.
It's okay, hon.
You said they'd find us.
I know, I did.
And until then...
Look, Clementine.
I'm not stupid, Lee. I know it's just pretend. But it makes me feel better.
Okay, you take good care of it then.
I will.
You'll be okay over here?
Uh-huh, I'll be okay.
I'm sorry,
Colin. How's it going, Lee? From up here, it looks like you're playing favorites.
Sleeping any better?
No. I know we should be grateful for beds, but no, I'm not.
Drugstore?
Yeah.
What should we do about the kid?
If it were up to me, I'd let him stay for a while, see if he proves to be an asset. But that's up to Lily, and with her in charge of the food, I don't want to get on her bad side.
Back in a bit.
Hey, is my friend gonna make it?
I don't know, but Kaja will do her best. I promise.
I can't believe you chopped off his leg.
There was no other way. How you holding up, kid?
I keep wondering if I could have done something to help, you know? Some kind of... I don't know. Something.
I'm sure you did all you could.
Yeah, maybe.
So who are you people? Our group's gonna want to know.
I'm Ben. Ben Paul. The man you saved is Mr. Parker, the band director at my school. We all came down from Stone Mountain for the playoffs when everything happened.
Relax. We'll get your friend back to normal in no time.
I sure hope so.
I think she gonna
be okay.
I don't know. Can you give me a hand real quick?
Yeah.
Sure. What do you need?
Just apply some pressure here while I try to close this up. You know, I thought I was starting to get used to this, sewing up people's injuries. But I mean, cuts and bruises are one thing, but Lee, this man has no leg.
I did the right thing.
Yeah, I know you did. The right thing is just scary sometimes, I guess. Well, you've done all you can, Lee. Thanks for the help. Go ahead and check in on the others. I need a little space here anyway.
That bumper sticker's the realest bumper sticker ever. Shit happens. I need to get that for my truck.
Will you hold the damn board steady?
I'm trying. I didn't realize I was getting this weak already.
What do you want? A handout? Oh, I got 60 cents in my pocket. If you'll shut up and quit being such a pansy.
Hey, you holding up okay, Lee? I was pretty fucked up back there, having to cut that guy's leg off.
Yeah, I just hope Katja can save him. You ever miss the Air Force base? I mean, this wall isn't exactly military standard.
No way I'm going back there. You saw what it was like when you guys picked me up. Completely overrun.
Lily's pretty pissed at us.
Listen, I know her intentions are good, but...
But nothing! She's making the smart choice. Those parasites you guys brought back need to go.
Sorry, there just wasn't enough food to go around.
I understand. Gotta be hard to make those decisions. Just get me next time.
Need any help with the wall?
Nope.
Actually, we could use your axe. You mind if we take it?
Yeah, give us that thing for a bit.
Here, Mark, this should help.
Thanks.
Hey, I'm the one doing all the work over here. You didn't think to give me the axe?
Come on, Larry. Cut Lee some slack. He knows you're just out to protect Lily. He told me so. Just like he's trying to protect Clementine.
I just need some food. Going this long without a proper meal make anybody cranky.
Ken, Lee, come here, please.
He didn't make it, did he?
He lost too much blood.
God damn it. I'm getting sick of this shit.
Ken, come back. There's nothing...
Let him go, Katja.
But...
He just needs time. It's been a rough morning.
That man you brought, I tried, but he was never going to survive.
Well, at least he's not our problem anymore.
What about the other kid?
Shit, Katja! Shit. That scared the shit out of me.
You okay?
Yeah, thanks.
Why'd you bring him here in the first place, asshole?
Dad, calm down.
You're gonna get us all killed! Why didn't you tell us he was bitten?
What?
He was bitten, and you didn't say a goddamn word!
But he wasn't bitten, I swear!
Well, your not-bitten friend here came back to life and tried to kill my wife!
What?
Wait, you all don't know?
What the hell are you talking about?
It's not the bite that does it. You come back no matter how you die. If you don't destroy the brain, that's just what happens. It's gonna happen to all of us.
God help us.
It makes sense. And Those first few days, it spread so fast.
Car accidents, suicides, everything was making more of them.
When I first saw it happen, we were all hiding out in a gym and everybody thought we were finally safe. But one of the girls, Jenny Pitcher, I think, I guess she couldn't take it. She took some pills, a lot of them. Someone went in the girls' room the next morning and... God.
Back off!
Whoa, lady, relax. Me and my brother, we just want to know if y'all can help us out.
I said back off!
Carly.
We don't want any trouble.
Of course, neither do we. I'm Andy St. John. This here's my brother, Dan. We're just out looking for gasoline. Looks like you folks got the motel locked down, which is fine, but if you could spare any gas, well, we'd be much obliged.
Why do you need gas?
Our place is protected by an electric fence. Generators provide the electricity.
Our generators run on gas. Look, we own a dairy farm a few miles up the road. If y'all be willing to lower your guns, we can talk about some kind of trade.
How y'all doing on food? We got plenty at the dairy.
Lee, why don't you and Mark check the place out? See if it's legit.
I'm going with you. I got your back if anything seems fishy.
So, what are y'all thinking?
You've got a deal. We'll bring some gas to your dairy. In exchange, you give us some food to bring back. We'll see how it goes from there.
Sounds fair. A couple gallons should power one of our generators for a while.
So, this dairy, you guys really have food?
Sure do. We lost most of the cattle, but we still have lots of milk, butter, and cheese stocked up.
And with the vegetables we grow, we got plenty of food.
It's nice to get away from that motel for a while. This Lily Kenny thing is starting to get ridiculous. Personally, I'd be happier if you started to take charge more.
You think they'd want me for a leader?
Sure. Everybody looks up to you.
Well, not everyone thinks I'm so trustworthy.
Because of your past. Does anyone else know?
Larry knows.
Great. That can't be easy.
Clementine might know. She was there when we were talking in the drugstore and asked me about it. I lied to her, but...
What exactly did happen with the senator?
You know what happened.
I only know what the press was told. I don't know your story.
Sometimes I wonder if I should talk to the group about it.
You don't have to. Whatever happened before things went to hell doesn't matter anymore.
Not sure everyone would see it that way.
Maybe you're right. Listen, over the years, I've reported on some pretty messed up shit. I've seen situations like yours 100 times. It doesn't have to make you a bad man.
I really appreciate that.
I mean, thank God Lee showed up when he did. Right, Lee?
Yeah, why don't you tell us a little more about yourself, Lee?
Where are you from?
I grew up in Macon.
Right here in the heart of Georgia. That's what I like to hear. Y'all seem pretty settled in at that motor inn. Who's running things over there?
Lily. She runs a pretty tight ship. Her and her dad are ex-military.
Yeah, she knows her shit, but she needs to know when to back off sometimes.
How many people you got over there anyway?
9, including the kids.
You forgot Ben.
Me?
That makes it 10.
Well, we'd love to get you all out to the dairy. Like I said, we got plenty of food, and quite frankly, we could always use an extra helping hand.
In the summers, I used to help out on a goat farm.
Yeah, that's great. Everything helps.
Mama's been running the dairy for, well, as long as I can remember, but now it's...
You think you're gonna cut me out of this? Shit, get down.
No one's trying to cut you out of anything.
You and Gary are always
fucking
pulling this
bandits.
Shit.
Who? Those look like the people who raided my camp.
Who are they?
Fuck you. You knew we were hungry. And you guys were keeping it up.
There's only 2 of them.
Oh no, there's
a lot more. Yeah, you know what? We ate it all. What are you gonna fucking do about it?
Don't worry. Danny and I got you covered if something happens. But let's just wait this out and hope they move on.
Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you!
Jesus!
Asshole. out here has gone to shit. Come on, let's get to the dairy where it's safe.
You think he put enough bullets in him? Jesus.
Here it is, St. John Family Dairy. Y'all can see how we kept this place so safe.
The fence keeps them out?
You betcha. They fry like bugs in a zapper. We're pushing 4,000 volts through that thing with generators and amps.
I'm going to assume that's a lot.
This is a really brilliant setup.
Suits us just fine.
This place looks untouched. You'd never know the rest of the world is in ruins.
It's worth protecting. Hence all the juice.
I thought I saw y'all with company coming down the drive.
Guys, this is our mama.
I'm Brenda St. John, and welcome to the St. John Dairy.
This here's Lee. He's from Macon.
A couple of our old farmhands were from Macon. They grow them good there.
They got a few more friends staying at the old motel.
Oh my goodness, that place is pretty vulnerable. Have you got someone with survival experience to lead your group?
We all work together. Plus, we've got plenty of people with military experience.
Well, that's good to hear. That motel ain't the safest place.
Hold on, I thought you said someone else was running things.
Oh yeah, I thought she was asking about survival tactics.
Well, it don't matter. You're here now. We'll make sure you're safe and comfortable.
We're awful hungry.
These are for y'all. Baked fresh this morning.
Amazing.
Can't get stuff like that anymore. Not without a cow for milk and butter, that's for sure.
That's right. Hopefully Maybelle will make it through this bout of whatever she's got and be with us for a good long while.
Your cow is sick? What's she?
We have a vet. We could bring her here. We can help you folks out.
A vet? Oh my! Our prayers have been answered.
Maybe our whole group could come for the day.
Well, how about this? Y'all go get your veterinary friend and I'll prepare some dinner. A big feast for all you hungry souls. It'll be nice to have some folks to help out around here again. Danny, why don't you come help me out in the kitchen?
Why don't I head back with the food and round up everyone for the trip over here?
Might want to take someone with you. Remember, those roads can be dangerous.
I can handle myself.
Take this. Why don't you go ahead and take Ben along anyway?
Take care of yourself, Lee. See you in a while.
Mark, Lee, why don't you take a look around? Once you get settled in, I could use some help securing the perimeter.
Is there a problem?
Sometimes the dead get tangled up in the fence before they fry and end up knocking over a post. It'd be a big help if you could walk the perimeter. You can learn a little something about our fence. I'm gonna go top off the generators before they run dry. Come get me when you're ready.
You betcha. This place is incredible. It's got food. And that fence? Oh man, that fence. If we play our cards right, this might turn out to be a place we can stay. So how do you want to play this?
Before we can think about bringing our whole group here to stay, we need to figure out if this place is as safe as they're telling us.
Right. Obviously, they think it's safe. But is it safe enough for the kids? I noticed a broken swing over there. Not a big deal, but maybe there's other things not working that we just can't see yet.
And this perimeter sounds like a decent way to get a good look at their defenses.
All right. I'll keep my eyes open, and you find out what you can from Andy.
All right, let's look at the swing.
Too bad it's broken. I'll bet Clementine and Duck would have loved something like this to play on.
Kids used to like that old swing even more than the tour sometimes.
I'll bet. How'd it break?
Got busted the first day those things showed up. Thank God no one was on it at the time.
Looks like it just needs a new board for the seat.
some rope, make it safe for Clem and Duck, and let the St. Johns know we can pull our weight around here.
That board should have fallen. It shouldn't be levitating like that, because it's not tied enough. It would have just, yeah.
Wonder how much food they've got in there. Hopefully we'll find out. Pointy.
Good observation, Lee. Pointy.
This is too big right now, but if I can find something to cut it down to size, this might make a good seat for the swing.
And right here, use the saw.
Mind if I use one of these boards?
Already making some repairs, huh? I like a guy who takes some initiative. Yeah, go right ahead.
Just shove it down my pants, you know. That's how it works.
Looks like the fence runs around the entire property, not just the house.
Yep, can't take any chances when it comes to safety.
Damn, I can't get zapped on it. Dang.
Hi. Well, I'm glad you guys decided to help us out. I noticed back at the motel that you folks are pretty well armed. Been stockpiling, huh?
Yeah, if you need some extra people to protect the dairy, you can count on us.
Well, hopefully it'll never come to that, but thanks.
We can't be the first people you've invited up to the dairy.
Well, no, we've made similar deals with other folks, trading for gas and food, but ultimately they moved on, looking for the people they lost contact with.
An electric fence is enough to keep out walkers?
Walkers? Is that what you call them? That's good. The old one wouldn't have, but Mac, he was our foreman, he figured out how to amp it up with the generator. We used to sit out here some nights and watch the sons of bitches sizzle and pop when they got too close. Closest thing to entertainment these days, I guess.
These generators are enough to power the whole dairy?
We got lots. We gotta keep trading for fuel as much as we can, but they all work together to do the trick. Like us.
I'm gonna get to know the place for a minute.
Okay, well, we gotta secure the perimeter, so don't take too long.
Let's go, fix that swing.
The board is good, but I need some rope.
Huh. Could there possibly be any rope anywhere? Maybe in this bucket. Rope. Yep.
This rope is perfect for the swing. This dairy won a lot of ribbons in its day, huh?
This place was my daddy's life. Meant everything to him. You know, when he first bought this place, it was a single-story house.
Is that right?
After us kids was born, he insisted on adding a second floor. Said they had to have room for as many babies as they could have. Mama, she was done after Dan.
My folks stopped after two as well.
Then one day, the world changed. Now this place is all we have left of Daddy. That's why we take such good care of it, and why we want to share it with good folks like yourselves.
Well, hi there, Lee. What can I do for you, sweetie?
Can I help you with anything around the house?
I think with Danny's help, I've got things pretty well squared away in the kitchen. But feel free to check with Andy. He's got a lot of weight on his shoulders these days, so I'm sure he'd love any help he can get.
Your family's done an amazing job of keeping this place up.
Well, now aren't you sweet? Thank you, Lee. The boys and I have tried to adapt as best we can, but we still keep some of our old routines to help remind us of better times.
When will dinner be ready?
It'd be a while still, but it'd be worth it. Trust me.
How's your family been holding up since, you know?
All my boys have been my saving grace. They both left their jobs and came home to help out after the attack started happening. I think it was hardest on Andy. Dan was always more of a mama's boy, but don't tell him I said that.
How many rooms does this house have?
Rooms? Why do you ask?
It looks custom built.
Nice of you to notice. My husband put a lot of work into this old house.
Well, he did a fantastic job.
I believe in making a house a home.
What happened to the rest of your staff?
Oh, we've had our share of tragedy here, just like everyone else, I'm sure. Some of our staff took off to find their family as soon as they heard the news. The few that stuck around, well, we lost most of them the first night those things showed up here. It was a tough night.
Well, if anything comes up that I can help with, feel free to let me know.
Well, Lee, I sure appreciate it.
No problem.
All right, let's fix that swing. Fix that swing. Fix that swing. Fix that swing.
All right, this shouldn't be too tough.
Well, I'll be damned. Mama's gonna be thrilled to see that old swing all fixed up.
Hopefully our kids will like it too.
Did you say something, darling? Oh, my goodness. Did you do that?
Just trying to help out a bit around here.
You know, I used to push Andy and his brother out here on that swing every night when they were kids. Seems like such a long time ago now.
Yeah, it does.
Alright. Now let's go ahead and check the perimeter. Now that we've, did a little bit of helping out. I'll talk to Mark.
So what have you found out? Is this looking like a good place to stay?
The fence is no joke, at least around the house. I'm looking forward to seeing the rest of it. I'll keep looking around.
Alright, keep me posted.
Alright.
Hi. Mark and I can help you with that perimeter now.
Oh, good. The fence will stop a walker in about 3 or 4 seconds, but gets overloaded if we leave the husks out there.
You know, Mark and I can clear the fence ourselves if you want to stay here and finish up with the generators.
Well, that'd be great. I'll turn off the northwest section, and if you guys could strip them off and look for any weak points, well, that'd be a big help.
Sounds easy enough.
Stay attentive. You never know.
So how's the place looking? Is it safe enough for us to stay? If we can?
It's pretty amazing what they've done with this dairy, but let's see what it takes to secure this fence before drawing any conclusions.
I can't wait until everyone's out here. Everyone besides Larry.
He wouldn't be such a pain in the ass if you weren't telling him we were talking behind his back all the time.
I'm sorry, all right?
We'll work it out somehow.
Well, hopefully he'll calm down once he's out here. There's one. Ugh. Lee, it's dead.
Come on, let's push it off. Disgusting.
Come on. I'm sure there's still a few more.
Once this fence is patched up, this place will be a fortress. God, can you imagine not having to worry about the walkers anymore?
Well, it's useless without gas. We might need food, but the St. Johns need gas, too.
Not many drivers these days, Lee. We could scrounge up a year's worth of gas, easy.
So what's your take on the brothers? They seem to have this place tied down pretty well.
What do you mean by that?
I don't know. They seem decent enough. I just want you to know that I've got your back if anything goes down. That's all.
Thanks. There's another one.
I see it.
Shorty short shorts.
You never get used to the smell, do you?
Nope.
Christ. I can't stop thinking about dinner. Would have been nice to get some of those rations. I get hungry too, you know.
I'm hungry too, Mark.
Do you think they're gonna be good for it? Dinner for a whole group of people?
If they've got as much food as they say, I think so.
Come on, I think I see where they're getting in. This one must have knocked it over trying to get through. He's tangled up in there pretty good. Come on, help me get this thing back in place so we can get Mr. Crispy off of here.
I think we'd get better leverage from the other side.
Good idea. Holy fuck! What just happened?
The fences are on!
Why the hell would he turn the fence on? He knows we're out here.
What the? Get to the gate! Get down!
You asshole!
Jesus!
We had an agreement! Now you're fucked!
Who the fuck is that?
No idea!
Fuck! Now what?
With the fence on, that gate is our only way out! No fuel!
Kill yourself! Did you really think you could fuck with us?
We don't mean you any harm, goddammit!
Try to lure me to the other. Over there!
Come on, if we can reach the gate, we can get through this fence and back to the house.
They're on the move! Shit, that hurts!
Do this all day. Behind the tractor!
What happened?
Oh, shit. It's one of the dead we pushed down earlier. Gonna have to move him.
Try to lure me to the open. What about our arrangement? Don't think I can't see you. Where do you think you're going? Can't hide forever.
Another one? How many of those things did we push down?
Did you really think you'd fuck with us? You fucked with us! Now we'll take what we want! I already got one of you! There you are, boy!
Hey.
You okay?
Yeah. Barely.
Come on. The gate's right there.
You got lucky. Give us the food. They're getting away.
Let's get out of here.
You lucky sons of bitches. Go ahead and run. We ain't going nowhere. What's wrong?
The electric fence came on. Some people started attacking from the woods, and we got trapped between them and the fence.
Holy shit, are you okay?
I heard Mark yelling. Thought y'all were giving me the all clear. Man, I am real sorry.
Oh, my Lord! What happened to you, sweetheart?
It was those bastards in the woods, Mama.
Yeah, I'll be all right once it's out, but God damn, it hurts.
Hey, y'all.
Mark, oh my God, what happened?
He got shot with an arrow.
Christ, are you gonna be okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I should just pull it out.
Oh no, honey, come on. Brenda's got you. Come on inside now. We'll have you all sorted out. Well, you must be the veterinarian.
What kind of shit is this?
We ran into some people on the way up here. Bandits, I guess. I think it was them that attacked us.
They gave us a lot of problems in the beginning. Killed a bunch of our farmhand. We were able to get them to stop by making a deal.
You knew about these people?
Food for protection. Not like we had much of a choice, but they did stop hassling us.
God damn it. Carly said this place was locked down tight.
Maybe it isn't as safe here as we thought.
Look, we're sorry. We never had them screw with us like this. Not since we started giving them food. Listen, we may have had an agreement with those people, but we will not stand for this shit.
Ain't no way we're gonna let those sons of bitches get away with this.
You know where these assholes are?
They're hard to pin down, but I think I know where at least one of their camps are. When you're ready to go scope out that bandit camp, come find us.
Bandits? Are you serious? This place isn't safe. We can't stay here.
Not safe? This place is a hell of a lot safer than that motor inn. I think all of us and our guns can handle a couple of punks with bows and arrows. What we need to do is find a way to get our whole group out here to stay. Take this place over if we have to.
Whoa, cool your jets there, Rambo. These are nice people. Let's not do anything to get us thrown out before we eat.
I'm gonna head out and help Dan deal with these bandits. You guys should try to make friends with Andy and Brenda while I'm gone.
Well, that's easy. I got charm coming out of my ass.
Yeah. That's real charming, Dad.
Where's Ben and Carly?
Since Carly and Ben ate some of the food on the way to get us, she volunteered to stay behind and watch the motor in until we get back.
Hey, kids, look what Lee got working for you.
A swing. I love swings, just like at my treehouse. Come on, Doc. Thanks, Lee. You're the best.
Yeah.
All right. Whoa, that was close.
Hey, Clem, you like the swing?
Yeah, it's fun. Thanks for fixing it.
You're welcome.
Will you push me on it?
Sure. Happy to push you on the swing. Mind if Clementine takes a turn?
All right, Duck. Let Clementine have a try for a bit.
Okay.
What do you think of the dairy?
It's pretty. It reminds me of how things used to look before.
Yeah, it does.
Do you think things will ever get back to how they were?
Yeah. I'm not sure when. One day, things have got to get back to normal.
That's good. I hope it's soon.
Yeah, me too. How you holding up, Clementine?
I'm okay, I guess. Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm just a little worried about Mark.
Is Mark going to be okay?
He got lucky out there. Could have been a lot worse.
Are you going to find the people who hurt Mark?
Well, we have to make sure they don't hurt anyone else.
Be careful. I want you to stay lucky, too.
Ever since I met you, I've had good luck, so don't worry.
Okay.
Don't worry. We're safe here now.
As long as the bad people don't get me, too, right?
I won't let what happened to Mark happen to you.
Promise?
I promise. All right, Clem, that's enough for now.
Okay, thanks for pushing me.
Of course, it's all yours.
Yeah!
Okay, Duck, don't pop a gasket.
Oh, whoa, that was. He almost kicked him in the face.
Hey.
Haley, found anything interesting?
I'm just trying to make sure this place is secure, in case we decide to make this a more long-term solution. Except for those people in the woods. Seems pretty safe.
Good to know. Keep your ears open for anything else that might help us.
Did Duck and Katja get here okay?
Well, it wasn't easy. Duck didn't look so good on the walk over to this place.
Well, if everything works out, maybe he and Katja can have an easier life here.
I hope you're right. Duck and Clementine deserve a better life than starving to death at some crappy motel.
How you holding up?
I hope they feed us, Lee. Soon. On the way over here, I was getting dizzy. Hands shaking, cold sweats. Thought I was gonna pass out.
They've got food here.
Yeah, but I'm not just talking about one meal, you know?
I guess, Lily isn't too thrilled about being here.
I could give two shits about what Lily wants. Duck and Katja need food, and I'm not about to sit around that motor inn and watch them go hungry. You're with me on this, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course. Lily's judgment is clouded, but you got a pretty clear head about these things. I'm gonna go have a look around.
Don't wait too long to help scope out that bandit camp. It'd be a good opportunity to find out a bit more about the St. Johns and their relationship with those bandits or whatever.
Right. I'll see what I can find out.
Hello, someone I don't even know. welcome to the stream of... Never mind. See what's in the barn. Anything?
If there's not enough room in the house for all of us, I guess a few of us could camp out here in shifts.
Sure, I guess so. I mean...
Looks like a feeding station for the cow.
Good observation, Lee. Good observation. Now I have a child,
Lily. Oh my god, I'm so glad you two didn't get killed out there. Do you think Mark will be okay?
Wish I knew, but I think he's in good hands now.
Yeah? It's not too bad?
He'll be fine. I've seen guys go through worse.
How could you all bring us to this place?
I take it you and Kenny didn't exactly make up on the way here.
I tried seeing things from his point of view, having a wife and kid and everything. But gambling with your family's life is pretty stupid if you ask me. Hey, thanks for backing me up this morning at the motel. I know I came down on you guys pretty hard, but you do agree with the way I'm running things, right?
You're a good leader, Lily. Kenny's too emotional, but his intentions are in the right place. Still, it'd be best for all of us if you two could try to work together once in a while.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll, probably, oh, that's just a cornfield. Probably go out and, scope that bandit camp. I think we probably should. Sooner rather than later. Alright, Lee, put some, oomph in your step.
Fellas.
How you feeling, Lee? Look, I'm really sorry you almost got killed out there. We should have told you how dangerous it was.
No shit.
You saw what they did to your buddy. Nobody's safe here until we start to fight back.
But how?
The two of us should go out and do some recon. Then we'll all mount up for some revenge.
Hell yeah.
Who the fuck are these people in the woods?
We don't know. I think some of them used to work at the big box up the way.
Save lots.
Yeah. Anyway, they're nutty as all hell and get mad when they're hungry.
You ready to head out there and find their camp?
Yeah.
It'll be a good opportunity to find out a bit more about what we're up against. Let's do it.
I'll stay here and hold down the fort.
Remember, we're just doing reconnaissance for now. No use getting ourselves killed.
Are you going now?
Yeah. I'll be back soon, Clementine.
Please be lucky.
I will.
We're gonna go out there and quickscope some noobs.
See anything?
Kidding.
Not yet.
I know it's around. Gotta be close.
Is that alphabet soup?
Here.
It's a camp.
You found it?
I don't see anyone over there. Looks like just a lot of empty stuff.
You see anybody?
Nope.
Looks empty.
Watch my back, Lee. I'm gonna check out the tent.
No one.
Clear. This camp's too small. It can't be their main base.
That's what I was thinking.
Take a look around anyway. There's probably some shit around here they stole from us.
Empty. But it looks like someone's been eating out of these. Recently. Nothing but fumes. Shit.
What's in the boxes?
They're all from save lots.
The first few days, they told folks to gather to the save lots by the interstate. Anything worth taking?
Not unless you need a bunch of empty cans.
I'll pass.
Yeah.
Boxes from the dairy here.
Probably the food we've been giving them. Fuckers cross the line.
Dropping carts.
I think we're moving a lot of stuff.
A kettle. Anything in it?
Just water. Nothing. Empty.
Huh. A recorder. What's that? A camera.
What do you find?
A video camera.
Let me see that.
Battery's dead, though.
Oh, good. What else they got over here? Let's see if we can find anything useful and then get a move on. I see you handled that gun I lent you pretty well. You a hunter?
No, but Lily keeps us all on a regular training schedule.
Lily, right. You did say she was running things for you. Sounds like you picked a good leader.
Take a look inside the tent. Bloody bunny.
Oh, man. Jesus. Is a kid mixed up in this?
was, more like.
And what's under sleeping bag number two? Huh?
The hell?
Don't you fucking move!
Shit!
Put your guns down. I ain't going back. You tell him Jolene ain't going back.
Hey, we had a deal. No shooting as long as we gave you food. What the fuck happened?
You had a deal with them. I ain't them. Oh, I know you. I know what you are. And I know what you do.
You don't know me.
Steal my shit. Steal everything from me.
We had a deal. You people broke it first.
Who the fuck are you? Look, it's not safe up here in the woods. You gotta come back to the dairy.
Oh, it's a hell of a lot safer up here than down there, you best believe. Now, maybe you didn't hear me last time. When I asked you, sweet, put your damn guns down. You think I won't kill you? I'm gonna take this here crossbow and put a nice sharp arrow right through your eyeball. Into your goddamn brain. You're not men. You're monsters. All men are monsters. Take what they want and then destroy it all. Take a can of beans. Take a little girl. It's all the fucking same to you.
Where did you get this hat?
The little girl.
You stole it from her.
So what if I did? You stole her from me.
What the hell are you talking about?
You know what? I changed my mind. I'm putting this arrow right through your balls. Yeah, right through. String them up on that tree. Then I'm gonna head down to that farm and shoot every goddamn person I see.
Look, there's two of us and one of you. No matter what happens, one of us is gonna kill you.
Like you could kill me. They couldn't kill me. They tried. Killing everywhere. Take all the dead folks you want. We'll make more. Go on. Tell him, boy. Tell him what you got in mind for us.
God damn it!
Well, thanks. I guess.
Well, you're welcome. I guess. It's a clean shot, though. Right through the forehead. That's good shooting right there. Still, what a waste.
So, that's it. We going back?
If they ain't here, I don't know where they are. And it ain't a good idea to go tromping through the woods looking for them. So yeah, we head back. Once they see this, they'll get the message.
What do you mean by a waste?
Come on. Man, that was a hell of a ride, huh?
Jesus, Danny.
What? You ain't getting soft on them, are you? Not after what they did to your friend.
You're back. What happened?
Handled it, Mama.
This isn't what Terry would have wanted.
Terry?
My husband. Miss him every day.
Then screw it up for everybody, then. Why don't you?
Oh, calm down, princess. I'll do it myself.
What's going on with them?
Don't know. Squabbling, looks like. A lot of tension with y'all, huh?
Yeah, you could say that. They don't exactly see eye to eye on how we should be doing things.
Well, it's probably just the hunger talking. And Lee? Don't worry your head about them bandits. I'm sorry you've seen more violence than I'd have thought in your short time, but you all are safe here. Don't worry.
Think I'll go have a look around.
Don't wander too far. Dinner'll be ready before you know it. And thank your friend Koch again for me. She and the kids are in the barn with the cow. That woman is a lifesaver.
Lifesaver. Uh-oh. That's a bad sign in games. If there's a thunderstorm coming, that's not a good sign. That there's a thunderstorm coming. Alrighty. Sure.
Hello. Glad I got to use her today. My girl here.
You really like that gun.
What's not to like? Exactly.
I'm gonna go wait for supper then.
It'll be a good one.
These guys are very creepy. I don't know. Where did Kenny go? There's a toolbox. It's in the toolbox.
Just gonna borrow this for a second.
I didn't take that. Don't look at me. Jeez. The thunder's really picking up. That is a bad sign. Whatever, I'll talk to you guys. See what the hell is going on.
Hey, so what happened at the camp? Did you guys find any more of those guys that hurt Mark?
We found a tent and some boxes. Nothing really useful.
Seriously? No food?
Jesus.
What were you and Kenny arguing about when I came back from the camp?
He's losing it, Lee. He comes over and starts talking about searching the barn and that these people are hiding something.
But you told him to mind his own goddamn business, right? We are guests here, and we don't need to be overstaying our welcome more than we already are.
The way I see it, we just need to skip the dinner and get our food to go. But I'm starting to think your friend over there has another agenda.
I'm gonna go check things out.
Just don't get too nosy. These kinds of people are usually pretty protective of their privacy.
Yeah, and we don't need you poking your nose where it don't belong and getting us thrown out in our asses.
Alright. I gotta check in the barn.
It's okay, Clementine. You can pet her.
It's okay. Go ahead.
Whoa. Katja says Mabel could have her baby tonight.
We'll see, Clementine.
What's this thing?
Daddy said it's called a salt lick.
Yeah, but don't lick it. It's gross.
Do you lick it?
You lick it?
I don't know.
That's the most guilty face I've seen. I'll give her a head.
Here, Clementine.
My hat! You found it! I knew you'd find it. You said you would.
Listen, did you give your hat to anyone?
No.
Did you see any strangers around the motor inn who might have taken it?
No. Why?
It's probably nothing. Just let me know if you ever see anything like that.
Okay, I will. Hey, Lee, do you think you'll ever have kids?
I don't know. I haven't thought about having kids in a long time.
Well, Thanks for finding my hat.
You're welcome, Clem.
Do you want to pet the cow with me?
Nah, but you go on ahead.
In these doors. Might as well look through. Then in that one. And what did it have maybe a look at? Oh,
just some fence posts.
Just some fence posts where cow is supposed to be, you know. No big deal.
I want to play in the hay.
Just stay close to your mom for now.
Okay.
Right. The magically closed behind you doors. Reminds me of Layers of Fear.
It's a feeding trough.
No way, Lee. Good observation.
Empty.
Oh my, that's a lot of stuff.
Looks like a bunch of old dirty clothes. Ooh, smells pretty foul.
You found it too, huh? Lee, they're hiding something behind this door. I got a quick look. They got boxes of stuff and something metal and sharp.
Don't get paranoid.
It's my job to be paranoid, Lee. I got my whole family on this farm right now. How about you? What about Clem?
I'll protect her no matter what.
I know you will. Look, that guy with Katya. What's his name? He locked it up real tight the second we came in. I definitely heard a noise back there, Lee.
What?
My point is, we gotta know for sure. So go find a hammer or something and I'll have this thing off in a second. You back me up in case them farmers come running.
Hang on, man. Think this through. You smash the lock. Then what if it turns out you're wrong? You just fucked your chance to get a good meal in those kids you're trying to protect. Use your head, Kenny.
All right, Professor. What'd you have in mind?
Let me have a look at what we're dealing with first.
Hey, Lee. You know how to pick a lock, right?
No. Why would you say that?
Well, you're, you know, urban?
Oh, you are not saying what I think you're saying.
Jesus, man, I'm from Florida. Crazy shit just comes out of my mouth sometimes. Sorry. What?
See those screws? Instead of breaking the padlock, we can just take off the assembly, have a peek inside, and then replace it all again like nothing ever happened.
All right. Sounds like you got a plan. I'll hang around and keep an eye on that guy with the cow.
Andy.
Shit, I thought that was Danny. Whatever.
Can I help you boys find something?
Kenny thought he heard a noise.
He's a little jumpy, huh? Well, we're all sure glad his wife is here. She's a lifesaver. You got no idea. Hey, do me a favor. Don't fuck around with this door, okay? Just, you know, Mama gets nervous.
Andrew, I need your help again.
No problem. Right away, Doc. Hey, guys, seriously, don't fuck around with that. Come on, enough already.
Okay. One. I think I know what to do. It's weird. It looks super dark inside the barn, but outside, it looks so bright.
So, how does a woman like yourself run this whole place?
Oh, I managed just fine. Plus, I had my boys to help out. I couldn't do it without them.
Guess I'm gonna need a screwdriver for this. There you go.
Why has it even given me the option to stick my hand in it?
Ow, damn it! The thing is moving fast.
Duh.
Thing is on too tight for my bare hands. There, that should do it.
Fucking Danny, where'd he find this piece of shit? Oh, fucking thing through a belt. Damn it, oh, son of a fuck.
And now it's super dark outside, even though it's just very bright.
Picked up something I think could help with the lock.
Nothing to stop you now.
All right.
Mom, Dad, dinner time! It's dinner time!
Okay, honey, let's get that.
Dad! Dad! Come on! Let's eat!
Kenny, come along, honey. Kenny, come on. Don't make the children wait.
I'll make an excuse for you. Get that thing off.
They're gonna find me. I don't like doing this. He's gonna walk in.
Boy, didn't you hear the bell? Dinner time.
Why was there so much blood in there?
Look, we have food here, but Danny and I still gotta do a lot of hunting to keep everyone fed. When we catch something in the woods, we skin it and dress it back there. Mama doesn't like us to make a mess in the house. So you see, nothing to worry about.
All right. That was a pretty heavy-duty chop saw.
Brenda, you are an angel.
Excuse the mess. We had to block the back door after a walker got upstairs. Don't worry. That was a while ago, and I ain't been back inside since.
Everybody can food up. You just let him rest.
Mind if I wash my hands first?
Bathroom's right outside in the hall. And be sure to get under your nails. You've been mucking around in the dirt all day.
Walkers aren't getting through that thing.
I'm gonna sneak upstairs. Go Right.
Musty as hell. What is this stuff? Looks like a bunch of medical waste in here. IV tubes, saline. What would dairy farmers need with this kind of stuff? What the hell?
Where is this? Why would they have the... Why is the bookshelf blocking the door? Oh no, what's behind it? Oh no.
Don't eat that!
Lee, Jesus, man. Did you find something?
Aw, oh, sit your ass down, Lee. This lady has made you a meal.
Yeah, Lee, what's gotten into you?
He just had a start.
Mark is upstairs with his fucking legs cut off! You're eating him!
That's crazy.
What the hell?
Damn.
You're the kids, Lee.
Lee, what the hell is wrong with you?
Don't indulge him, Lily. There's always something with this guy.
Mom, I was eating that.
What is going on?
Go upstairs and look. You'll find a guy with both of his legs hacked off. This is a dairy, not a ranch. Think about it.
It's...
Everything could have turned out okay for you folks.
He would have died anyway. We gotta think about living.
Settle down, honey. Growing up in rural Georgia, you're taught not to waste. It's... raised and how I raised my boys. Now, you got monsters roaming around that do nothing but eat people. And for what? To continue to rot till they eat some more. We think we can put that meat to better use.
Oh, I'm gonna puke.
You're all sick. Sick in the head.
Lee, that's not a very nice thing to imply. Andy is right. We go after folks who were gonna die anyways, one way or another.
Like y'all.
Clementine, run!
Nobody's going anywhere.
We got lots of use for y'all right here.
What the fuck? The fucking what?
Put
fuck?
Your guns down! We're walking
you
out of here!
Don't go near my fucking family!
I don't want to die. Mommy, what did I eat?
Everyone, everything will be okay.
Lee? Lee?
Let go of her, you son of a bitch!
Oh no, what was that?
Please! Someone!
Keep up! us in here! Open up! I will tear you fuckers apart with my bare hands!
We gotta find another way out of here!
You sick fucking bastards! Open this door, goddammit! I will knock the goddamn door down!
It was a person. They tried to make us eat a person.
But you didn't do it.
No.
The rest of us did. Damn it! If you hadn't dragged your feet...
Come on, Dad. Now's not the time.
You okay, Clementine? They didn't hurt you, did they?
Mm-mm.
Open up!
Lee, those psychos have my family, and we're stuck in a damn meat locker. We gotta get the fuck out of here!
This goddamn thumbsucker was the one who brought us here!
Will you all just shut the fuck up?
I'm scared.
Don't be. It's gonna be okay. I'm gonna find us a way out of here.
You're worse than the walkers!
Dad, please! Please, settle down!
I'll rip your goddamn heads off and make you I'll break that damn door down!
Dad, you can't get... Easy!
Oh, God.
Dad? No! Dad, come on! Dad! Oh, God. He stopped breathing. I think he's had a heart attack.
Shit. Is he dead?
He's not dead! Somebody help me!
Fuck. If he's dead...
He's not dead!
You know what has to happen, Lee. Think about it. You saw that poor bastard at the motel? How fast he turned?
What are you saying?
Lily, I'm sorry. I truly, truly am. But in a few minutes, we're gonna be stuck in a locked room with a 6'4", 300-pound, seriously pissed off dead guy.
Fuck you! We can bring him back! Lee!
We'll mourn him later. But right now, we have to keep him from coming back.
No! God damn it, Kenny! He's not dead!
We can't kill him if he's not dead, Kenny.
You remember how hard it was for you to get that monster off of Katya? And Larry's twice his size. It's him or us.
Look, Kenny, back at the drugstore when we all thought Duck was bitten, I gave him the benefit of the doubt. Maybe we should do the same now.
That was different. Duck wasn't bitten. But come on, we know this guy's not gonna make it. Remember what Ben said. Gotta destroy the brain. Come on, Lee. You can't be in the middle on this one. You gotta have my back this time.
God damn it, Lee. I need you. Please help me.
I'm sorry, Lily, but...
Come on.
So.
Fucking monsters! Both of you!
I don't want to see!
I'm sorry, Lily.
No!
It's the only way.
Get off me! Don't do this! No! Let go of me! No! Please! No!
God help us. I'm sorry.
Fucking touch me!
Clementine. Clem. You okay?
Why, Lee? Lily said he wasn't dead.
He was dead, Clementine.
But what if he wasn't?
He was, I promise. Shh. I know. But you gotta be strong right now. I need you to be strong. Think about something else, something hopeful.
Like what?
Getting out of here.
We're gonna get out, right? You found a way out?
I'm working on it. There ought to be an air duct behind this unit. Maybe big enough for one of us to fit through.
I don't know, Lee. Seems like a long shot.
Does the air conditioner come off?
I think I could take it off if I had something to remove the screws. The multi-tool. Of course they took it. Shit.
Maybe there's something else we could use. I've got a rock.
A rock won't help, but a coin might do the you have a coin?
Mm-mm.
Mm-hmm.
Lily, I'm sorry.
Don't talk to me, Lee. Don't fucking talk to me.
Larry would have wanted...
Fuck you! You think he wanted this?
Of course not.
You don't know what he wanted. You never knew him. You never gave him a chance.
Maybe not. Maybe I should have tried harder. But I know he loved you. He'd want you to get out of here. I think I may have found a way out of here. But I need something to remove the screws on the air conditioner. If you had something I could use as a screwdriver, a coin or something.
No.
What about him? Look, I know this is a terrible time for it, but back at the motor inn, Larry mentioned something about keeping coins in his pockets.
In other words, my father's more useful to you dead than alive.
If he was alive and had the key to getting us out of here, do you think he'd keep it to himself?
What do you want? My blessing to loot his corpse?
Your permission.
Do what you have to do.
Oh, boy. Any idea which pocket he keeps his change in?
You fucking vulture!
Here we go.
Alright, yes, it's right.
And a dime. Screws and get this unit off.
You got it?
Yeah. One more should do it.
It's a Georgia quarter.
Our way out, Lee.
We don't know where it leads.
Looks like it'll probably lead right into that back room.
I can find out.
I know you're brave enough.
I'm scared.
Remember the treehouse? You held out for days.
And I saved your life.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay.
You're gonna be fine.
What do I do when I get out?
See if you can get to the other side of that door and open it.
God's sake, Lee. Didn't even get to say goodbye.
Get in here. I got an idea.
Stay here. Take care of Lily, okay?
I will.
Oh, that's a noose.
I told you there was something up with this room. It's a goddamn human slaughterhouse.
Hmm.
Watch your step. That's slippery.
Two prongs, I like.
I think I'm gonna be sick. Oh God, what's wrong with these people?
Friggin' miter saw.
Jesus, this is where they butcher people.
Sick bastards. All of them.
So what's the plan?
That dumbass is so caught up in his own rant that we could probably sneak right up on him. Just stick behind me in case anything goes down. When we get to the front, grab his gun.
Sounds good.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah, let's go.
Stay close.
Dad, what are you doing outside the barn?
Oh, shit. Just guarding the place, like you said.
Well, quit sitting out in the rain like a damn weirdo. Mama says we can't keep that many folks alive and not expect trouble. Pick one to keep and kill the rest.
Can I pick which one to keep alive?
Not the kid. Not enough meat on her to trade.
Oh, I know, Mabel. This is my favorite part, too. When I let one think they can just walk right out, they never even look down.
Hey, Yorkie's inside. He's not coming any closer. I'll keep an eye on him. Be ready to act when I say.
See what he's doing now. What do you see?
I don't see him anymore.
Where the fuck did he go?
I don't know.
Look again. He didn't go past us. See where he is now.
And I knew it. Oh, shit. Panicked. Oh, he had a sickle. How's that for one of your own bear traps?
Where's my family, asshole?
You can't have them. We need the vet.
No!
Can't! Lee, come on!
Just go. I won't be far behind.
You see? You understand now, don't you? You can have me. It's how the world works now. Give part of yourself so others can live.
Cannibalism is not the answer. Aren't the walkers eating enough of us?
You gotta keep me alive. If you kill me, the meat gets tainted. You can't eat it.
You're already tainted.
You ain't gonna kill me. Just like he didn't kill Jolene. You don't have what it takes. Fucking coward.
Oh, that's it.
No! God, no!
Katja!
Just go. I'll keep Clementine safe.
I wasn't gonna keep him alive. You crazy. As soon as he said that I wouldn't kill him, went right for
Kenny.
It. See, it's always a thunderstorm, you know? I knew it. I knew something bad was gonna happen. Yeah. It's Carly.
Carly!
Lee?
Ow!
Shh! Is everyone okay? We heard screams as we were coming up to the house.
They attacked us!
I knew it. I told you we couldn't trust them.
Shit! How many of them are there?
Two left.
Where?
Larry's dead. They chopped off Mark's legs and tried to feed them to us.
Shit. Is everyone else okay?
They've still got Duck and Katja in the house. And I don't know where the fuck Kenny is.
All right. We're coming in to help.
The main gate is too dangerous. Go around the fence and see if there's a back way in. I'll keep looking for Kenny. Do you have a weapon?
I don't leave home without it. Ben, stick close. And Lee, be careful.
I'm gonna take the boy and check around.
No, please don't take my boy.
Let go, woman.
Set him down. I don't want to hurt y'all.
Andy? Danny, is that you? What's going on out there?
Yeah, it's me.
Oh, God.
Come here. Let me go.
Lee, get back. Don't come in here. You just had to go snooping around, didn't you?
Let her go, Brenda.
Lee, please don't you take another step.
Brenda, come on now. You know you don't want to do this.
Just go away and leave us be.
Think about what you're doing. It doesn't have to end like this.
I'll kill her, Lee.
Just let me go.
Stay back! Don't do anything stupid!
Let her go, Brenda.
Please, listen to him.
I'll do it!
Please.
Kill you, Lee!
Please don't make this any worse.
Just stop!
Mark's gonna save the day.
I said, don't move, asshole!
Don't you fucking hurt him!
Oh my God!
Let him go, goddammit!
That ain't gonna happen!
Andy, don't!
Shut up!
Andy! Who the fuck do you people think you are? Look at what you done! You brought this on yourself.
No, you did this! All we wanted was a little gas to keep ourselves safe.
It's like Call of Duty 3. But you have to push the gun.
Lily, help!
Is that all you got, Lee? You ain't shit!
It's over!
Fuck you! As soon as Dan and Mama get out here, you all fucked!
They're both dead!
What did you do? What the fuck did you do? Don't you dare walk away from me, Lee! Get back here and finish this, Lee!
No. I'm not killing another.
Get back here and fight me like a man, Lee! Lee!
They're getting in!
Lee!
Let's go.
Thanks a lot for helping me, Lily. Bitch.
Hey, Lee. I'd say I'm sorry for leaving the motel unattended, but, you know.
I'm glad you showed up when you did. If you hadn't taken that shot at Andy, we might not have gotten out of there.
Were they really killing people? For food?
Yeah.
Yeah, they were.
That is sick. God, just... ugh. Clementine, she doesn't know, right?
She's not stupid, Carly.
Katja managed to grab this while she was in the house. She said it was with your stuff.
Yeah. I found it while I was looking for the people who shot Mark. Do you want it?
Why don't you keep it? Sometimes it helps to have something you can document your thoughts on.
How are you doing?
I'll be fine. Just not as young as I used to be. Hon, go on ahead and give me and Lee a second. There's gonna be fallout.
For killing Lily's dad? Yeah, I would imagine so.
What do you think?
I'm with you, Kenny. We'll do what has to be done.
You're damn right. Listen, that RV back at the motor inn is just about ready. I've changed my mind. I want you to come with us when we leave.
Yeah?
Hell yeah. We're a team, man, me and you. By taking out Larry before he turned, you saved all of us in that meat locker. And that saved my family, too. Yeah, I'd say you earned it.
Come on, Clementine. Stay close.
Lee, did you have to kill those men?
I'm sorry you had to see that, but I only did it to protect us.
Because they tried to hurt us?
Yes.
Okay.
Hey, Dad. What's that noise?
Sounds like a car.
Oh, God. Not more strangers.
No one would leave a car like that unattended. They would have closed the door.
Hello?
figures.
Oh, crap. Baby, you gotta see this. It's a shitload of food and supplies back here.
This food could save all of us. Not all of us.
Look, we don't know if these people are dead.
If they come back, then we're just monsters who came out of the woods and ruined their lives.
This stuff isn't ours. Dad, whose car is it?
Don't worry about that, Duck. It's ours now.
It's abandoned, Ducky. Don't worry.
What if it's not? Well, what if it's not abandoned? What if it is someone's?
We have to take this, Clementine. We need it to survive.
Who says it's your decision to make?
Hey, we don't have time for this shit. Like it or not, we need this food. Now get over here and open the trunk, Lee.
You didn't even try to save me, whore.
It's locked.
No shit, I already tried that. But I heard you take the keys from up front.
Yeah.
Supplies?
I'll take it.
Great. Maybe we'll survive this after all. Duck, why don't you carry this?
Okay.
More food in here. Got a box of food here.
I'll carry it.
This hoodie looks to be about your size. Why don't you hold on to this? It might get cold.
It's not mine.
We're not like the bandits, honey. We didn't hurt anybody to get this. Understand?
I guess so.
Hey, there were some batteries in one of those boxes. I thought they might work in your camcorder. Here, you can have some too. For your walkie-talkie.
Batteries, huh? Think you can handle those?
You're not gonna let me live that down, are you? Oh, God. Lee, you're gonna wanna see this.
Oh, shit.
Jake, Bart, Linda, and all y'all fucking sickos from the save lots. They call y'all bandits, but you're fucking rapists. What?
Oh, darling baby, look at you. Look at you. Oh, you need a mama, sweetheart. We won't let them bandits get you, will we?
No.
Okay.
Where's your hat?
I don't know. Can you help me find it?
Sure. When did you lose it?
I had it a couple days ago.
I promise. If
y'all
I find
thinking
it,
you're
I'll
safe?
You know.
Sitting there acting like things are the way they used to be. The dead don't kill their own. It's the living you gotta be afraid of. The people I used to call friends. People who took... Don't worry, little girl. Bandits got their eye on that dairy. As long as they keep getting food from them, you'll be safe. I promise.
That's creepy.
Making is done, pal. Ain't nothing left. We gotta get the hell out of here. Lee, I need you to back me up on this.
Is this all you got?
I told you this town is tapped. Do you have any idea what we had to do to get all that? We need to leave.
Duck was asking about the farm last night. Not much phases in, but it's starting to add up. I need to get to the coast. Get him out of all this madness. Lily's not doing so good, huh?
But we killed her dad.
We did kill her dad. Maybe people out there got things lined up better. Better than us, at least. Could be folks who have all this shit figured out.
Do people get mad when they're scared?
Sometimes, yeah, they do.
This is crazy!
I'm the one keeping this group going!
We can sort this all out, all right? We can sort this out!
I'll tell you what we need to sort out. We can't let one person fuck this up for everyone else!
Oof. Alright. I think good choices. I mean, only 43% chopped his leg off. I mean, had to try. Helped kill Larry. You know, I had to. I wanted to be able to stick with Kenny. I didn't kill. I wasn't gonna kill both brothers. One brother, yeah. The other brother, he can suffer. And stole food from the car, yeah. I mean, that's a pretty polarizing one. That and killing Larry. Alright, so that was episode number 2, Starved for Help. Hope you guys all enjoyed. Gonna go back to the main menu. And next episode will be coming up soon as well. What's the next episode again? Long Road Ahead. Stay tuned for that episode as well. And if you are enjoying this series at all, leave a like down below. Or subscribe if you want to see more videos. Follow me on Twitch as well, so you can see all of them live. Thank you guys all for watching, and I hope you have an amazing day. See you all next time. Goodbye, everybody.